Hello everyone, it's Vicky. We're here today to test out a brand new standard size chunky insert. So stay tuned. Hello everyone, it's Vicky. I am here today quickly to jump in as fast as I can to talk about a new traveler's notebook. I shouldn't say traveler's notebook, a standard size insert for a traveler's notebook. And I saw Sarah Martinez talk about this on her YouTube channel, and I literally was in it like 2 seconds, and I was like, I need that in my life immediately. And it comes fast, let me tell you. The shop that is doing them, it comes quickly. From what I've gathered, I've read a few blogs on the paper that I'm going to talk about that's within this insert. Oops, I got some my kids' stickers in there. The insert itself, look how thick it is, first of all. And it's standard. I didn't cut it down. It's a standard size. It has paper called Cosmo Air Light. From my understanding, this paper was a sampler in one of the pen shows, and people went gaga for it. And I, from what I've been hearing, Sarah mentioned, this is supposed to make, like Tomoe River Paper kind of run for its money, basically. This is supposed to be just up there for a lot of the Tomoe River lovers of that paper. This is, you know, right up there with it. I am a huge fan of Tomoe River Paper, and I love the 52 GSM Tomoe River Paper, not the 68. There is a difference. The 52 is obviously thinner. A lot of folks prefer the 68 GSM because there is less shadowing and ghosting that appears on the other side. I personally love the 52, which is the one you'd find in the Hobonichi. That's my all-time favorite one. But this one, I believe, is a 72 GSM. So it is a little bit of a thicker paper, but there is a little bit of a interesting feel to the paper in that it has a little bit of tooth to it compared to what you'll find with the Hobonichi paper. The Hobonichi paper has a very slick surface, and as many of you know, the reason why a lot of things can do well on that paper is because Tomoe River paper has a coating on it. Coating that is on the Tomoe River paper is really what helps the paper not absorb, and therefore things are not really penetrating through like you would normally see. And it sits on top, but of course the delay and dry time is one of those drawbacks that a lot of people aren't always fond of. For myself personally, it's not an issue. I tend to usually put a pencil board in there, and that kind of helps alleviate some of the issue, or a blotting paper sheet in there, and that kind of alleviates some of that issue. For me personally, it's just not one of the challenges that I'm faced with, because if you're a fountain pen lover, the paper is everything. If you don't have appropriate paper to go with your fountain pens, you're really kind of almost wasting your time, because you're not getting the full experience, especially when you're getting all the inks and you're collecting all the inks and you want to see all the sheens and the shimmers and everything else. You definitely want to have the right paper. So as someone who is obsessed with paper, I can't get enough of it. That we'd have a lot of fun going through this insert, and of course seeing the chunkiness of it. I am noticing, I did see Archer and Olive had come out with a thicker insert as well for like the standard size. We haven't seen that really on the market, especially in this kind of binding format. So this has a Coptic stitch, which you'll be able to feel. I'm not sure if it'll come up on camera, but you can definitely feel it. And it has, I mean, so many little signatures in here, hand stitched, and your stitching is, I mean, like almost right next to each other. So it's bound beautifully. It is like just beautiful, lay flat, incredible. The color of the paper has a slight kind of cream color, like a soft on the eye, so it's not that super stark white. But I do happen to have a MD next to me, which, you know, MD paper is known for that more of a, that creamier color. So you'll see the difference there in the color. So it's definitely lighter in color, closer probably to the moleskin. This, by the way, is side note, but this is the MD notebook journal. It's, I believe, called the Codex. It's got grid paper in here. Unbelievable. Amazing. The binding on this is fantastic as well, but I'll save that for another video. Today we're going to play with this Cosmo Air Light. I did bust out a cover for it, and I'll have a couple of more covers to discuss how it fits. I also brought my chunky moleskin just to share with you how pens work on this paper, so you can see the difference with how it works on this paper, as well as kind of a standard that I got from Apple Pig Grid. This is really good paper as well. I did want to show you some of those because I feel like those paper variations are relatively similar. And then I want to show you how it fits in different traveler's notebooks, because the issue you're going to run into with a thicker traveler's notebook in the standard size is obviously the amount you're going to have to accommodate to fit the spine. So when you have a thinner one, you won't run quite into any issues. Now, I have this, which is one of my all-time favorites ever made standard size that Cody had made for me. And he no longer has been in business. He hasn't been in business for years, probably not since 2015. And I look for any excuse to use this traveler's notebook. I absolutely love the leather on it. It has a very like caramel kind of feel to it. And you'll see that with the enforced spine on this one, it allows and accommodates for that extra room perfectly in here. I mean, it's just like, it was almost like it was made for this insert. It's absolutely perfect in here. I do wanna share and show you what it looks like in your standard kind of Midori, and then a couple others. Okay, I've got some beautiful cover options to go with here. This is your traditional Midori in black. I just did some embossing on a while back. This is from Sojourner. Rowena makes this. This was one of her like special pebbled leathers, but Rowena is known for her very slim and sleek line. This is the Castle Pemberley, I believe, from Chic Sparrow that I've had for a while. And I believe this is in a wide fit. And then this is from Naked Cow. If you guys have been watching for a while, you'll know this was the Cherry Ice from Naked Cow, and I love this very much. And so we're gonna try it in all of these notebooks to see how it fits in all of the standard size, because that may be a deterrent for you if your favorite cover is kind of within one of these and it doesn't fit. So this is a standard size. This has the floating pockets in here. For myself, I would never use the elastics. I would use this back elastic for the back cover to slide this guy in. And then what we're gonna have to do is put our floating pocket in there and then close it up. And so you can see it gets accommodated beautifully. So you know this is gonna be my notebook for Christmas, because it's my absolute favorite red leather. It's absolutely stunning. I love it. If you guys remember the unboxing of this, let me know down below and give me a thumbs up. Let me know if you remember that. So this is how I would utilize this. I would not utilize it on the elastics. If I needed it to stay open, I would utilize this guy over here. So this fits beautifully in this guy here. Next, we have the Pemberley. So this has one of the Planner Perfect inserts in here. So if you're familiar with that size, these are more of that kind of wider fit for the standard. So you can fit probably the K here moleskins in there. So if I were to put it in here, again, I wouldn't love to use the elastic on it, but if you're okay with that, here's how it'll fit within this notebook. Just to give you an idea, it fits just fine. It fits beautifully within here. There's no issues. There's no overhang, nothing like that. I love the rounded edges. There's a lot of attention to detail in that regard. If you watch Sarah Martinez's video, you can see a lot of the detail and a lot of thought process that went in there. This is Rowena's standard. And again, her whole thing is to have the very slim and sleek appearance with your notebooks. And so here's how this guy looks. Now, because again, she's going with a very slim and sleek, her leather covers it, but there is a little bit of an overhang. I can try and push it just a little bit more in there, but I mean, it's perfect. Let me put it that way. It fits just perfect, like just right. It fits on there. Okay, so gives you an idea there. And then last but not least, I've got the Midori. Or is that Midori anymore, right? It's Travelers. But mine is the old school one. That was one of the very first ever. So it still says Midori on the bottom there. Okay, it's Travelers Company now. And this guy, if I were to put it in here, okay, it's gonna fit with just that. So you can't pop any more inserts in there because it's gonna fit like just barely with that. Okay, that's how that's gonna fit in there, to give you an idea. So that's how the covers fit. I personally am gonna go with that red, beautiful, the cherry one, the cherry ice from Naked Cow from back in the day. I'm gonna go with that one. And then for now, since we're still in fall, I'm gonna go with this cover for it right now. But just to take a look at the paper, let's take a peek in on the inside. I'm gonna go in the back because I like doing my pen tests in the back of the books. Here I've got a Conklin. This is one of my absolute favorite because I love the tortoise on there. This nib is, I want to say, a medium nib. It doesn't have, or it doesn't have it easily for me to see. Oh, maybe it's a broad. Oh, maybe it's a broad. Let's see. I want to say it's a medium, but it could be a broad. So this is a Conklin. Let me put this under here because it's a thicker notebook. So we've got the Conklin. It says it's broad on the thing, so we'll go with the broad nib. Beautiful in regards to how it writes. There's a little bit of grip when I write across it, so it's not as quite as slick, but that's not a problem. It's a nice thing. As far as how the ink sits on there, I'm sure the wetter pens that we're going to look at, it's probably going to, you know, take a little while. This definitely would smudge. If I put my hand across it, it would definitely smudge. This is my Twisby 580. I've got diamond sands in there, so it's got a very glittery, like, type of ink in there. This is one of my absolute favorites. This is also in a broad nib. So this is my Twisby. Oh, I love it already. Love this ink and pen on this paper. Oh, I mean, it sounds beautiful. Not only that, immediately when I wrote with this, there is the shimmer that's within the diamine shimmering inks. You see it immediately on this paper. If I write on, let me show you. This, for example, has kind of more of a standard paper insert in here. Still good quality, still high quality, like it won't bleed through. But if I write with this guy, okay, what happens is, because I'm not writing on paper that's necessarily made with the fountain pen, I catch a lot of, like, hiccup when I write. There's a lot of tooth. I catch a lot of hiccup, and you barely see in person that shimmer. On this paper, it, like, pops off the paper, which was another thing that the Cosmo Air Light is, why the community went crazy, is it has this ability to make the ink pop off. Sarah does a really good job of explaining this, but it really, like, this literally pops off the page as I'm looking at it compared to this. Yes, I see some of the shimmer. Yes, I do see some of it, and you may as well, but boy, does it pop with it. Like, you literally see the shading with it, and it just pops. It's got a beautiful, oh my gosh, it's incredible. This is going to be such an enjoyable experience if you're a fountain pen lover. Oh my gosh. This guy, this is from Woodshed Pen Co., the gentleman who makes pens over on Instagram. This is his a Yowo nib on there, which I love this so very much. So this is my Wood shed, pen, co, broad, nib. Oh, that's pretty. And oh my gosh, I can't believe how, so you'll see it sits wet right here, so it didn't get absorbed, so it's gonna sit probably wet for a little while. But the beautiful part of that is probably it's gonna add some of that beautiful ability to see the color. I already see the difference here, and I'm gonna compare it once again here because I've never seen this color like I'm seeing it right now. I've never seen that. So if I write over here, all right, wood shed pen co. Okay, writes nicely. Not the end of the world. You know, I'm not like, oh my God, this is awful. Nothing like that. But the color looks completely different. It literally pops. It like comes off the page. It looks three-dimensional. Like it looks amazing compared to here. It's very flat. On here, it's a very flat kind of color. Off of here, it's almost like, oh my gosh, it's almost like it was printed. You know, if you look at something that was printed on like a really nice high-end flyer or like a high-end like handout that you received, that's what that looks like. And it was like printed with this beautiful like inkjet. That's what that looks like compared to here. Here's very kind of flat looking is the only way or the best way I can explain that. Then this is one of my absolute favorites. This is another Woodshed Penco, and this one has the 1.1 stub on it, which I absolutely love this pen. I'm obsessed with this pen. And this I'm excited for. Wow. Wow. I can see why people went nuts for this paper. It's incredible. So as it's drying, you can see it's wet. It takes a little bit, but this, I'm not going to say this takes forever to dry. This looks like it dries relatively quickly. There's some spots here that still look like they're a little bit wet. And then to show you on like our more regular standard kind of paper here. Okay, still looks pretty. There's nothing like awful, but man, does it pop off that. It's like so smooth on there. Here, it doesn't have that same look. I'm so excited about this paper. It is so beautiful. Oh my gosh, is it beautiful. It's absolutely stunning. Then I have this is a Franklin Christoph. This was, I think, their Sex and Candy. It's got a beautiful red, like, tip there, and this has a green ink in there, and I think this is their medium, yep, medium nib. And this is, let's see, this isn't quite as wet, but very beautiful. Wow. If you're familiar with Rhodia, Rhodia has that very slick kind of surface as well. This one doesn't. It's got like, I want to say it's like furry, but it's almost got like if there's like this, the most minuscule kind of velvet that you can run your hand across, that's what I would say it has. It's absolutely breathtaking. It's incredible. This is a Sarasa clip. Let's see. Okay, Sarasa. So you're definitely gonna feel the, with the Sarasa, you feel it on the paper with that velvet feel. You'll definitely feel that. And then my, clicker here, what is this? Oh my gosh, why am I blanking out? Oh my gosh, and mustard, this is the vanishing point. This is a fine. Very beautiful. Writes very nicely. Very, very, very lovely. I also brought some Tombows just out of curiosity to see how they worked on here. And it just feels so vibrant on this paper. Like there's something about this paper that makes things really stand out. Like very, very vibrant. Wow. It just, I don't know what it is. It looks extremely vibrant. So let me just show it to you. I know there's grit on this one and the dot on this one. But I swear to you, it's like, I don't know, it just makes it pop off the paper. It's incredible. Now watercolor, that'll be interesting to see how it takes watercolor. Luckily I have some brushes here and some watercolor. So let's just, out of curiosity, let's see. Let's do a blue. I have M Graham. Let's just, out of curiosity, oh wow. That goes really nice and smooth on there. Look at that. No pilling. That went actually very nicely. Okay. Let me see another color. Let's do like a bright red or more red color. Oh, that's smooth. Oy, that's a very enjoyable experience. Wow. That is nice. Wow, wow, wow. Holy cow. That's a very, very enjoyable experience right there. Let's do a yellow, kind of yellow orange. Oh, look at that. Wow, that is pretty. Ooh, that is pretty. Oh my goodness. Oh my, my. Wow, that is, wow. I don't know what to say. I was looking for like a flaw because Rhodia, when I tried to do watercolor on Rhodia, I felt like it was a huge fail. The paper did not do quite as well, in my opinion. But wow, that is nice for watercolor. If Obonichi picked this up, it would be a game changer. I'm not even exaggerating that. This, if Hobonichi picks this up, it would be like, I don't know. I think it would, I don't want to say be an improvement, but holy cow, it'd be a really up one notch experience, really. Because this watercolor now, holy cow. You can see, excuse me, I got a frog in my throat. You can see that it sits on there for quite some time. You'll see that with Hobonichi as well, so nothing new. And then just to show you on the back, I mean, literally nothing is really even ghosting. There's some ghosting. You will definitely have the wrinkling like you would with the Tomoe River paper when you add the water. Wow, what an experience with the water. Like, I'm shocked at the vibrancy of this. Like, that's pretty much dry. That's dry. The pink there is almost dry. I mean, these are all... they're all pretty dry. So in the time that I'm yammering on to all of you, this is pretty much dry. This is incredible. What a game changer. It's definitely going to be on the higher end of price, and it's coming from Japan. But you're not finding very many people that are actually binding this paper. It's coming in a notepad. Have no fear, though. I have a feeling that people will catch on and begin to buy the paper pads and make inserts like this. I feel like the same thing happened with Tomoe River paper. It was the same thing. You could only get your hands on the pads, and then all of a sudden people started making the inserts. So I have no fear in that regard, but wow, I'm speechless in regards to how it took to the watercolor. Like, this looks so beautiful to me. I love how the fountain pens went on there. I knew it was going to do well because I watched their Sarah's video, but wow. I love it. I'm so excited to be using this. There's plenty of paper in there. It feels amazing. It feels so good. I will link the shop down below if you guys want to check these out. They're incredible. If you've heard of the Cosmo Airlight, let me know down below as well. I want to hear your thoughts. If you got one of those samplers, I did hear that there were some folks in the community that did have the sampler and were familiar with this. This is incredible. Breathtaking. 5+ stars for me across the board. It's definitely, I can't wait. Thank you all so much for watching today, and I'll see you again soon. Take care.